Somebody give these babies a big round of applause. Welcome everyone. Welcome everyone. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Come on now, Merry Christmas one time, everybody. That's how we do it, amen. How about a big happy birthday, Jesus? One, two, three. Amen, amen. My wife is going to come sing for you guys tonight. Would you give Miss Mary a big round of applause? Oh, music. Amen. God is so good. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Let me get my elders to come forward and pray. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Y'all got to move a little faster, boys. Amen. Thank y'all for coming to Caney Creek Cowboy Church, our Christmas Eve service. God is so good. Amen. Is this on, David? Testing, 1, 2. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Kids, close your eyes. Amen.
Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, we just come to you in prayer this evening, Father, and thank you for this beautiful day that you've given each and every one of us, Father. Be with these kids this evening when they put on their play, and let it be a blessing to all, Father God. We just think we do it all in the glory for you, Father. Father, be with those who are less fortunate this season, and just bring joy to them, and somehow, and be with all the people that are in our church that are sick or under the weather. Just look after them, Father. And I ask Jesus in your name.
Father God, I come before you this evening, Lord. I just want to tell you, thank you, Jesus, for the wonderful year we've had here at Canyon Creek Cowboy Church.
Yes.
Lord, we've got so much accomplished this year. And Lord, it's all been because of your grace, Father, and your blessings upon our church, Father. Father, I thank you, Lord, for showing favor on Canyon Creek Cowboy Church this whole year, Father. And Father, I just pray, Lord, that you'll be with all the families here tonight, Lord, as they go through their Christmas seasons and New Year's, Father. And Lord, just put a hedge of protection around each and every person here tonight, God, and just keep them safe, Father, through these Christmas and New Year's seasons, Father. Father, I ask you to come down tonight and touch each and every one of these special little babies tonight that's going to be performing for you tonight, God. God, I just ask you, Lord, to let them, help them out with their lines, God. Be with them while they perform for you tonight, God. And they want to show out to you, God, and show you, Father, how much they love you. They're doing this for you tonight, God. So, Father, I just pray you'll be with them, Lord, and let them make it through their play tonight. It's going to be so special to see them, Lord. Lord, I pray you'll be with Pastor Mark tonight as he brings the message, Father. Lord, hide him behind the cross, Lord. Use him to speak to the congregation, Father, so your message will be received. Father, I pray that every heart tonight here is open and they receive the message, Father. Father, I just pray, Lord, that you'll be with him also, Lord, and help his voice get better, God, so that he continue to preach and deliver your message, Father. Father, I just ask you to be with each and every one here tonight, Lord, and bless them in all aspects of life, Father, and whatever they're going through, God. I just ask you to lift it from them right now and let it stay at the foot of the cross tonight, God. And let us all remember, Father, this Christmas season is you, God. It's all about you and not us. Lord, I praise you and I thank you, Jesus, for blessing me and my family, Lord. In your holy, precious name I pray tonight, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
We're looking for the King, the new Messiah. We're following the star, shining brighter. Oh, Lord, won't you help us if you can? He shook his head, but he pointed his hand. There's a new kid in town, and he's lying in a manger down the road. patience. Sometimes the truth is lost. Every step this baby took brought us closer to the cross. The perfect dream grew very long ago. And it was not decked with silver or with all the rats of gold. Hanging from its branches was a gift for you and me. Jesus laid his life down on the perfect tree. Very long ago.
Sister Mary, a big round of applause, amen. One thing we've done this year, turn down just a little bit, Mike, Matt, David, turn down the mains. One thing we've done this year is we've done a lot to get Jesus Christ's name out there. From the beginning of this year, like Brother Richard said, we've accomplished a lot of great things. We've gone to two services at Caney Creek Cowboy Church this year. And I'm reminded tonight that we do have a full church. Somebody say amen. You come to the early service, you might see some empty chairs and you might see some more spots. But I want to tell you tonight, there's a spot for you. Come on, somebody say amen. Come on, these kids say amen. There's a spot for you at Caney Creek Cowboy Church. Whether these are your grandkids, maybe your neighbor's kids, maybe your aunt or uncle, maybe you're visiting from out of town, get yourself plugged into a good church. Amen. And watch your life begin to change. Amen. How many lives begin to change because of this church? Raise your hand. Somebody give God a praise. Amen. Well, Miss Sarah and Miss Mary, Ona and Oni and I can't even, Jamie, they work very hard with these kids. As they come right now, I want you to give them a big round of applause as we start our kids program, their first Christmas. Come on, kids.
Oh. a virgin named Mary. She was to be married to Joseph for the family of the King of David. She spoke to Mary.
God has blessed you more than any other.
because you believe that he will keep his promise. He has also blessed the child he will have. Why should the mother of my Lord come to me as soon as I heard your greeting? My baby became happy and
With all my heart, I praise the Lord, and I am glad because of God. My Savior cares for me, his humble servant. All people will say, God has blessed me, and God, all powerful, has done great things for me, and his name is holy.
Mary began singing and praising God. Lead the angels in singing. Hark the herald angels sing.
Hark the herald angels sing. Glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild. God is with us. Joyful all the nations ride. Join the child of the sky.
Comes to Joseph in a dream to let him know that is it okay to marry Mary, because Joseph is a good man and is thinking about calling the wedding off quite quietly as not to embarrass Mary after he finds out she is with child.
Joseph, Mary is with child by the Holy Spirit, so go ahead and marry her. And when he is born, call him Jesus, because he will save his people.
Mary stayed with Elizabeth for 3 months, and then she went back home. After some time returning home, it became time for her sentence to be taken to Emperor Augustus and order the names of all the people to be listed in recorded books, and everyone had to go to hometown to be listed. So Joseph took Mary with him to Bethlehem because they were engaged to be married. Mary rode on a donkey because she was with child and about to give birth. When they arrived, Joseph went to all the inns, but there was no room. So he went to the farm and knocked on the door.
Joseph takes Mary to the barn and they settle in for the night. But during the night, Mary gives birth to a baby boy, all sing Away in a Manger. Some shepherds were guarding their sheep. All at once, an angel of the Lord comes down to them, and brightness of the Lord's glory shone all around them. And the shepherds were so afraid, and the angel said, Suddenly, many angels appeared, singing and praising God. They were saying, "Praise God in heaven and earth, singing joy to the world."
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And
thank you.
because the angel had said.
Let's go to Bethlehem and see what the Lord has told us about.
When Jesus was born, three wise men from the east came to King Herod and asked about Jesus. King Herod was a selfish king and was filled with hate. And the wise men gave them to him. The wise men were warned in a dream not to return to Herod because he really wanted to kill the child, so they went back by another road. Wise men sing, do you hear what I hear?
Thank you.
hot chocolate and cookies and help us celebrate Jesus' birthday. To all a good night from Candy Creek Cowboy Church.
Good job, kids. Turn that mane down, David. Somebody give the kids a big round of applause. Hallelujah. You're okay. Sit in those rows. Sit in those two rows, baby. I think these kids did a wonderful job tonight, amen? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a fine job them children did. You think it's easy, you come do it.
I'll be home for Christmas.
I mean, remember that old Honey classic.
You can plan on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on.
Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Kids, we'll get them costumes later. Just sit down. Sit down, guys. Shh. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord God, it's so good to be in your house tonight. Lord, I'm so honored to serve tonight with all these children. I'm so proud that these kids know about Jesus. And they learn out here in your house, Lord. Lord, it's just amazing.
Pray,
seek God, and seek His wisdom, and seek His understanding, and seek His knowledge and His ways. And Lord, I know when it's time for these kids to go home, you'll be standing there to receive them. Bible says, let the little children come. I don't know why in this world where more and more and more evil pops its eerie head up, just like all those babies that are home to celebrate Christmas this year. I don't understand why that happened. But I know that's a good lesson for the rest of us. To bring our kids to God's house. Amen. Teach them God's ways. Let's bring God back to school.
Amen.
In 2013, let's do something about it. Let's put ourselves under God's authority. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I want to talk to you for just a minute. Turn it up just a hair. Somebody hear me this morning. I want to say this from the bottom of my heart. Kids, y'all got to let me talk. But don't worry about taking them off right now. Sit still. Sit still. Let me say this morning. Tonight. We're here tonight. I've been a little under the weather, if you can't tell by the way I talk. I want to say this. After what happened a little over a week ago, with all those babies losing their lives. Moms and dads, if that's not a wake-up call for you to get your children closer to God, I don't know what is. I don't know what is. I'm going to say this. Everybody was saying, where was God? Where was God? God was there. God was there. God was there in those rescuers that ran into that school to get it to stop. It might have already stopped on its own, but I'm going to tell you that when those babies received that, there was God there ready to receive them.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
What if that was us? What if that was us? You know, that's hard to understand. It's hard to swallow. But I guarantee you, after we all saw that on TV, we hugged our kids a little more. Amen. We told them we loved them. We even thought about holding them from school the next day. But did you know what happened the next day? That every crazy fool came out of the woodworks and started saying, we're going to bomb this school, we're going to shoot up this school, we're going to do this damage over here, we're going to do this at the mall, we're going to do this. Brothers and sisters, it's time for us to get right with God.
Amen.
So that we can teach more and more children about the Lord. What if it stopped? What if it stopped with that older generation? It ain't never stopped. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It hasn't never stopped. Since the birth of Jesus Christ, it hasn't never stopped. There is no other name on earth above Jesus Christ. It ain't never stopped. It'll never stop as long as we have breath and we tell the story of Christmas. If we tell the miracle of Christmas. The sad problem is, brothers and sisters, too many people know the story, but they don't live for it. You know, I love that old song. I'll be home for Christmas. I love about Christmas, we all get together. Don't you love to see those family and friends when they come over? Oh, the house smells so pretty. It's so decorated. I'll be home for Christmas. Man, I love Christmas, and I love to celebrate it. It's my favorite holiday of all times. But I want to say this tonight. Listen to me. We see our friends, we see our family. Watch this. We're on our best behavior in a perfect world. But in our real homes, there's drugs and alcohol. In our real homes, there's violence and cancer. In our real homes, there's abuse and neglect. In our real homes, there's molestation. In our real homes, but Jesus was born so that we could experience a real heaven.
Amen.
Somebody ought to praise him for that tonight. Come on, somebody ought to praise him tonight for that. Somebody ought to praise him tonight for that. You know, we hear the songs, we see the lights, we get ready for the presents, we're all dressed up, we're on our best behavior in a perfect world. But in a perfect world, we don't live. A perfect world awaits us for those that believe in the Jesus Christ. A perfect world awaits us for those that believe in Jesus Christ. It's a place called heaven. You know, it saddens me. And so many people don't believe in Jesus right here in America. I'm not talking about foreign country and foreign land, but right here in America, more people say there ain't no God. Some of y'all might be a little skeptic. I'm going to say, from the first miracle, he's still working miracles.
Amen.
Did you know this? Pay attention. Did you know this, that some of these babies were preemies? Some of them were born 1 or 2 pounds and they're still alive. That's a miracle. Some of them were born with diseases and different things like that, but they're still alive. They're still healthy. Did you know this, Tony, that some of these kids are going into the same type of environment in their school that those kids faced in their school? But God's still working miracles. Wow, somebody ought to praise him. Jesus was born to die for our sins. He was born that me and you might have a way to get away from this home here and have an everlasting home in heaven.
Amen.
The Bible says, in my Father's house there are many mansions. If it was not so, I would not say it. A place where no more sorrow, no more shootings. A police officer lost his life today. He's supposed to be off tomorrow for Christmas to spend with his wife and his children, but some evil took place and that man's never going to make it back to his earthly home. But they said he was a God-fearing man.
Amen.
He's at home having the best Christmas. You know, I want to stress this and I'll be done. Absence from the body says presence with the Lord.
Amen.
Everyone that dies will go see the Lord. But not everyone will see heaven. We need to wrap our mind around that tonight. Everyone that dies will go see the Lord, but not everyone will receive heaven. The ones that will be going to heaven are the ones that ask God to forgive them of their sins. And that are living for Him. They are living for Him. This year can be so different with your help, brothers and sisters. This year can be so impacting for more children to come to know Jesus Christ. I think we baptized almost 464 people this year. Unheard of. But brothers and sisters, every head bowed, every eye closed. The only way this Christmas you can be sure of your salvation, be sure you're going to make it to heaven, is by accepting Jesus Christ into your heart. I'm going to ask you to do that tonight. These little kids got you here tonight. But it's Jesus that will get you to heaven. Your good works, you being a good person, you giving, none of that's going to get you to heaven. It's Jesus Christ that will get you to heaven. Home for the holidays. Yeah, we get to come home on this earth right now, but there's also going to be a holy day where we get to stand in the presence of the Almighty Jesus Christ. It'll be a holy day. I'm going to ask you tonight, if you've never prayed and asked Jesus to come into your heart, will you do that with me right now? Will you say, Lord, I give my life to you this Christmas. Lord, I haven't been living for you. I haven't been doing the things that honor you, Lord. Let me say this tonight. Pray with me right now. Say, Lord, come into my life and save me. Today I make you my Lord and Savior. God is not a God of do's and don'ts, a bunch of rules. He's a God of love. And if you love Him, you'll obey His rules. He loved you enough that the Bible says, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, and whosoever shall believeth in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life through Jesus Christ. If you believe in Him tonight for the first time, I want you to pray. Say, Lord, come to my life and save me. Today I make you my Lord and Savior. Please forgive me of my sins. If you prayed that for the first time in your life, let me see your hand. Just slip your hands up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the back, 6. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Maybe you're here tonight and you grew up and you knew religion. Your grandma drug you to church. Your mom and dad made you go to church. You know religion. And religion, I'm going to say it, Lord. Religion's what hung Jesus on the cross. I'm going to ask you, do you have a relationship with Him? You say, Brother Mark, not the relationship that I want. Because I'm still doing things that I really don't want to do anymore. Good. Tonight's the night you can change everything about you. I got a gift for you. And that's the gift of rededication. Rededicate your life to Jesus tonight. Rededicate your life to Jesus tonight. Live for Him from this day forward. Become such a soul winner that every angel in heaven will know your name when you get there.
Amen.
Be real quiet. Can you see that long line of people standing there trying to get in the pearly gates? And they call you out of the crowd. They say, come on in, Brother Harry. I know what you've done. Come on in, Brother Joe. I know what you've done. Come on in, Brother Benny. I know what you've done. But what if you're standing there and they don't know your name? Put your name in the book tonight. The Bible says your name's in the book. It can never be erased. Rededicate your life to the Lord. Know Him in a personal way, with a way of relationship tonight. Pray to Him. Talk to Him. Listen to Him. Merry Christmas. May God bless you and keep you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody give God a praise. I want to invite you guys tonight. I want to invite you guys tonight to listen to me. To stay in fellowship. I'm going to let the kids go first at the cookie table. Because they've done such an amazing job. Brother Vic, come close us out with a word of prayer. Kids, go ahead and get your costumes off. Go ahead and make your way to the back. Leave your costumes right where you are. You can only get one cookie. Harry said, man, you better not tell me about one cookie. Yes. Let's pray together. Brother Vic. I pray you have a Merry Christmas. Turn to your neighbor and tell them to have a Merry Christmas. Touch three people and tell them to have a Merry Christmas. Touch three people and tell them to get to church next Sunday. Come on, you witnessing now. Look somebody in the eye and say, get to church. God loves you. Amen. There we go now. Here I close. Brother Nick's going to close us out with prayer.
Let's all bow our head and go to the Lord in prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for being with us, leading us, and guiding us. Gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for all these lovely faces here tonight, these brothers and sisters, Lord. Thank you for letting them come see what the Lamb sent her done, Lord. That was a real blessing, Lord. Real heart-touching to see where our youth is going. Gracious Heavenly Father, we ask that you be with that officer who got killed today. And be with his family. Hold his family in your hands, Lord. And lift them up, Lord. And we ask that you be with the gentleman that run out to his aid and got killed, Lord. We ask that you be with him and his family. We ask you be with the family in Newtown, all the families, Lord. Be with the whole town, Lord. Put a hedge of protection around all of them, Lord, as they celebrate without their loved ones. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we ask that you be with the ones that couldn't make it tonight, the ones that were in the hospital, and the ones that are out on the highway. We ask that you be with them and see them back home. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for dying on the cross. Happy birthday, Lord. Thank you for all your blessings and everything that you give each and every one of us. The most important thing that we receive is eternal life. Thanks to you for dying on the cross for us. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we ask that you thank you for the message that we received tonight, Lord. We ask all these things in your name. Amen.
God bless you. Thank you for coming. You are dismissed. Someone was asking where they could give an offering. There's some offering containers on the side. If you'd like to give an offering, it's on the sides. There is a barrel in the back. God bless you.
Hey, you better be kept for all you did. Yay. You're good.